news earlier this year and had a chance to talk with Rick Kua. Mm-hmm. And this coming up next is Our Time with Rick Kua. Really neat guy, bass player, formerly of the Outlaws. Mm-hmm. Followed by his video, I Can, I Will. And welcome to Victor Videos, Rick Kua. How you doing, man?
Good to be with you.
Good to be
doing?
With you. Real good.
Good. Terrific.
Well, we're here at ICFUS, and you guys did a great job up there.
Thank you.
Really enjoyed your music.
It was a good day. Great audience. Wonderful day. As always, good to be here.
That's great. Well, you were on our, we'd interviewed you a couple of years back, and I had not had the chance to meet you at that time, but I'm glad to have you on the program today.
Thank you.
Let's talk a little bit about when you got started back in the old days. You started out playing in the basement bands and in the bar scene, and mm-hmm. Grandma bought you your first bass, I read.
Yeah, that's right.
64
Precision.
P-bass.
P-bass, yeah.
And then you got into secular music. Tell us a little bit about that for those people who don't know.
Well, you know, I wasn't saved back when I started playing. And I just loved music, and I would play anything. And obviously, it was secular music that the world was listening to. And I got involved in that, and I learned about music. And everything from jazz to rock and roll to R&B, dance music, whatever it was, I wanted to know how to play it and play it well. And I did that for many, many, many years. Got with a band called The Outlaws in 1980, which was a pretty world-famous group, and
sure.
Stayed with them for 3 years, a little over 3 years. Did a couple records with them. They were gold in several countries and had a good taste of the big time, so to speak. But when I got saved, I realized that God had something else in mind, and I began to pray and eventually started making contemporary Christian records.
In 1989, your number one hit song that really jumped out there, I Can, I Will.
Yeah.
What was that all about? I mean, that must have been just really neat.
That was about meeting a lot of people that didn't believe in themselves because of Christ, not because of the flesh, but if you've got Jesus living in your heart, you've got to know that you can and will get the job done, man, that you can do mighty things for God. And too many people say, oh, I can't do it, that it never happened to me, oh, it'll never happen in my life. Too much negativity. If you've got Christ the King living in your heart, then you can and you will. You can do all things through Christ who strengthens you. And that's something we got to hang on to that and believe it.